Hey, I'm photographer David Bergman, and this is 2 Minute Tips for Adorama TV. You may have tried to upload an image online for either a book, a print, or even just a website, and were told to upload at 300 DPI. Today, I'm going to talk about photo resolution and explain why people are so easily confused about it. Okay, so here's the most important thing to remember. The only way to determine the resolution of a digital photograph is to know the number of pixels actually in the file. There are a lot of programs like Photoshop that'll tell you those dimensions, but on a Mac, you can also set it to show in the Finder or hit Get Info and it'll give you all of those numbers. If you're asked for a file at 300 DPI, which is dots per inch, they actually mean PPI, which is pixels per inch. That tells you exactly how many pixels are squeezed into each inch of that image. If it's going to be 1 inch wide at 300 pixels per inch, then you only need 300 pixels across. If it's 10 inches wide at 300 PPI, then you need 3,000 pixels. The other big mistake that people make is that they only look at the size of the final file once it's saved out. The most common file format is JPEG, and that works by compressing the image down to make it smaller for delivery. You can choose the level of compression you want, and in Photoshop, it goes from 0 to 12. The lower numbers compress the file a lot more, making it much smaller, but you lose a lot of quality. So I generally like to keep my JPEG compression from around 8 to 10. But here's the thing, no matter how much compression you apply when saving a JPEG, it doesn't change the actual number of pixels in the image. The resolution stays exactly the same. So I can take two images at different resolutions and easily make the higher resolution photograph into a smaller file by saving it at 8, for example, while the other image is saved at 12. When you look at the actual pixel dimensions of the photographs, the smaller JPEG file is still the high resolution image. So whether you're trying to print a book, make a holiday card, or just send a photo to a friend, make sure your images are the correct resolution no matter what size the final file is. Thanks for joining me today on Adorama TV. Don't forget to subscribe for more amazing videos, follow me on social media @David Bergman, and go to the Adorama Learning Center for lots of other great tips and tricks.